The most common question that I usually receive is about optimization. People write me that their Blender scene freeze or even crash whenever press the render button, despite the availability of powerful RTX video cards, while others want to do something having only a bad laptop. But can optimization really help, and how to optimize the Blender scene so that it works even on a calculator? I don't want to upset you, but not how. Everything you have to know about optimization in 3D, before I show you how I usually do this, that is not a magic stick. And if your project requires 64GB RAM, you can't change this directly. And if you have a laptop with 8GB RAM, almost nothing helps you to run this scene, but something we can do. The first is to correctly estimate your capabilities. Do what you can do with the capabilities of your computer and work with projects that are possible to work with your device. After we understand that, let's move on what we can really impact in Blender to optimize the Blender scene. The first thing we can do to optimize the Blender scene is to use the inner settings of the Blender. The Blender itself can help you with optimization and it's hidden here. Simplify. This is disabled by default in the Blender, but I always enable the settings and save it as the default setup. It helps if you are rendering with video card, because the video card resources are very limited, or if you don't have a lot of RAM. We can set limit for viewport and render. Max subdivision allows you to set the maximum value of subdivision in the whole scene, especially relevant if you use a lot of displacement with large values of subdivision, and texture limit, which saves significant memory consumption. I use a 4K limit texture for render and 2K for the viewport. But remember that this may lead to lose the quality of texture on the render if you originally use 8K texture, that means the Blender reduces it to 4K. This is easiest way and first thing to start optimization the Blender scene if you have limited resources on your computer. Despite the fact that I have 64GB RAM and 12GB of video memory, I still use Simplify, and you may see the difference between enabling Simplify and disable. I usually disable this only if I need in some situation when I'm making 8K renders, but it not always, more depends on situation. Another optimization relates to the viewport. If you have a lot of trees, grass and other small details, just select them and make visibility in viewport display as bounds. This is hide the object and leave only the bounding box of this object in the viewport. The same if you are using scatter. Everywhere you can find such familiar icons for viewport and render visibility. We can compare this viewport before optimization and after. It seems much faster and more comfortable for work. Unfortunately, this doesn't impact the render. I mean, the rendering all this hidden object will work as basic object. So this is only for viewport optimization, but this is also necessary if you have a large landscape. Think about optimization from the start. When you open the Blender, already think about optimization and viewport optimization, also important things. It doesn't matter how powerful a PC you have, you must think about optimization from start to finish. If it's a commercial project, you don't know what your client will get to put in the project when you get comments from them. And you may have some situation when wishes from your client can't be implemented in the project due to already running off resources. Also, as trite as it may sound, we can use collections to optimize a complex scene. Many artists completely ignore the use of collection, which is not right. I can select all my background objects and put them into one collection, do it for the foreground and some middle ground objects, and place here all collections related to this part of the scene. So now my scene is divided by collections, which I can turn on or turn off, and most importantly, I can render it separately and then use compositing to get the full image. This may help make Randolph large scene even if you have a bad computer or not enough video memory. I talked about how it works in my YouTube and Patreon videos. All links to these videos are in the description, so you may watch them for more details on how this wave works and what the benefits of using this rendering method are. So, when we realize that collections in Blend exist not just to be in the Blend interface, let's consider another way of optimization the scenes that I use, but we will return to collections because I have something to show you yet. In classic painting, we have such a method when everything in the foreground we make with high detalization, and then far from the viewer we can reduce detalization. Originally it was called the air perspective. Those who study at art school understand what I'm talking about, but that's everything acceptable in digital art and 3D art as well. And this method allows us to optimize resources in large landscapes as well, because we don't need detalization on the far distance in your scene and possibly use low poly models there. Or even use image background as I used in this artwork. Here only foreground and middle ground are in 3D, but the background is just a simple image of mountains that I took on FreePix stock. Optimization is also such a trick, you know, as I said, it's not magic. Touch is a goal, always are good and nothing bad if you use some other stuff, such as images for the background, for optimization work, if they fit perfectly into the project. So imagine how many resources would be needed if I made these mountains in 3D. Of course, sometimes it's justified to do everything in 3D, if this animation and there is a movement of camera, all depends on the project and goals. I will not tie to saying planning a project from the beginning. This is the main part of the optimization. Optimization is not only about saving resources from the very beginning, it's also about thinking about the next step, or even couple of next steps, depending on your experience, and using proper way, proper models. In some parts of your art possible to use different tricks and reduce the quality of background models. Do not use such high poly detalization in some places, they are not visible in the camera. In other words, it doesn't mean just take a bunch of 3D models, drop into the Blender scene and getting the system out of the memory message. Also, I have a scene where I have a problem with optimization. Even a lack of optimization. It's just a simple scene that I did for my Adobe Stock portfolio on sale. By the way, if you want to learn more about how to make simple images in Blender and sell them on Adobe Stock to make passive income, follow the link in the description to my Blender masterclass. But this scene pretty well depicts what the optimization is. So, I just made a render and we may see that estimated render time is around 1 hour. But what if I do the same in this Blender scene? Now estimated render time around 10 minutes. But what is the reason and what I did in this scene? Everything is absolutely simple. Look at this first scene. As we can see, it's absolutely messy scene with a lot of trash objects. Yeah, I'm talking about optimization, but sometimes I also forget to do optimization and remind myself this only when the Blender is crashed or render time going to the moon. And yeah, all this trash is not participating in the render because we can't see them in the camera, but here's one problem. These candles. Seems behind the scene, but they are inside the volume cube as we see, and the light from these candles also impacts the render because volume cube, so we can see their effects. But in this scene where the render time was okay, I hide all this object in collections, as I mentioned before, and this section is optimized render time, just get rid of trash from the scene. This what seems to be a tried situation, but it has led to the time of the render being increased by 50 minutes. It seems simple, but I see a lot of situations where an artist ignores use on collection and clean up their Blender scene, and they ask why Blender crashed. That's why. clean up the trash from your Blender scene and organize the scene by collections. This not only helps you optimize the scene, but allows you to control what happens in the Blender scene. And here's a way to work that will not mess up your scene at all. If you use another 3D models in your scene, don't drop them into main Blender scene without checking. Because this is a common mistake to drop a known model into your working scene, which may lead to crash or damage the scene due to we don't know if this model is correct at all, especially if this model is free. Use two Blender scenes. The first one is your main scene where you're working, and the second one you use for checking models. So I use the sketch for add-on to download the scan of ruins, and I can check, remove some parts if it's necessary, or just clean up the model, maybe even use Decimate to reduce the density of topology if this model for some backgrounds. Then I copy this model and place into my main scene. In this case, I accept any errors that may be associated with this model in the future. So, optimization is not some magic button that turns your Blender scene into a clean one and everything starts render. No, optimization is a set of actions that you must remember every time from the very beginning and always think about the next step. If I do match density mesh here, will be good if I add more object on the next step. As you noticed, I always compare digital art with traditional art, because when you draw something, you are making this step by step, not making some details here and then moving to the next step. The same is acceptable when you're working in 3D scene. Do not rush making a lot of from the very beginning. Think about the next step and add details constantly throughout the whole process. Use collection, do not miss something in your scenes, and think about why the render crashing. Because most likely some bad model came to the scene that caused problem on the render. Optimization is about thinking. Thinking about each step and each action you do. Thinking about if I add more density in the mesh to get a better quality displacement, then will I have enough resources to finish this project? So, in the end, I would like to return to what I said at the beginning of this video. If a scene needs 64GB RAM, it's not possible to physically run it on laptop with 8GB, just because there is no memory to load this scene. The opening may still be possible, but the rendering is already not. And I'm going back to this point that all optimization is possible when there is a resources to do something to render the scene. Therefore, it's always important to start with understanding of your maximum capabilities and build your process on these, then thinking about step-by-step working. Unfortunately, it doesn't work another way. Otherwise, all the artists would be working on computers for $200. And yet, if you do not have a cool computer, not enough resources, and even optimization doesn't work for you, do not be upset. Get a good tip as you can make great art even on grandma's laptop. In one of my YouTube videos, I showed a great way to make realistic art using 3D and mod painting. This way allows do not use high quality render, but make a simple scene and use photobashing techniques to make amazing art. This combination of 3D and 2D, but the result will be also amazing despite you didn't render it in a Blender. This method is not related to optimization in Blender, but I know that many beginners artists work on what they have and can't always afford to render big scenes at all. Maybe for someone it will be useful if nothing already helps from the optimization. Also subscribe to my channel, Patreon, Instagram and other social. If you have any questions, leave them here in the comments or better in my Discord. All links in the description. So, see you in the next video.